Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a closer look at how you can animate your MetaHuman character's face via Unreal Live Link. iClone provides a number of excellent facial animation tools for both expression and Lipsync that are guaranteed to speed up and enhance your workflow. Let's take a look at a quick example first.
iClone MetaHuman Live Link brings MetaHumans like me to life. This is much more easier and manageable than you imagine. Just focus on your creative directing and storytelling instead of controlling hundreds of rigs. Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering or even with iPhone tracking.
Learn more about iClone MetaHuman Live Link, you can check out our webpage here. You'll find the link in the description of this video. Please also be sure to watch the Getting Started video to learn how to get everything set up first. Once you've followed the instructions in that video, you will have these files imported into your Unreal project. It's important to note here that the Getting Started video also shows you how to replace the face animation blueprint with a customized one for use with iClone Live Link. There will be some slight modifications, including a remapped pose asset node and a node that sets some minor curve adjustments for the mouth. Let's move on to the project settings now. You'll want to start by connecting Live Link in both Unreal and in iClone, like shown here. You'll note that the character in iClone is Deborah, so to find the equivalent naming in Unreal, we need to go to the L-Link Face Subject field and select the Deborah, which is the target we sent to Unreal. You'll also want to ensure that you enable L-Link Face Head to allow for head rotation. Once everything is set up, we're ready to do some facial animation. Let's take a look at AccuLips first. This is a quick overview, but there are more detailed tutorials you can find in our training center. What I'm going to do is go to Create Script from our Animation tab and select AccuLips. Then, load in our audio file. We can play back to test it out.
Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering.
Once we're satisfied, then let's go to Generate Text, which will transcribe the words being spoken in the audio so we can confirm the lip sync accuracy. You can manually adjust the text if it transcribes incorrectly and then hit Align. After that, we can apply and play back.
Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering or even with iPhone tracking.
In iClone, you can adjust the talking style of your AccuLips clip to match various scenarios. Enunciating will create a more exaggerated result like you see here.
Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering.
There are other presets you can choose, and you can also feel free to customize the sliders.
Let us talk with accurate lip syncing. Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering.
Aside from that, you can also customize the individual visine keyframes in various ways as well.
Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering.
You can also do facial mocap with various devices in iClone. In this case, I'm just connecting the iPhone Live Face Profile in the Motion Live Mocap plugin. You can preview the results right away, and when you're ready to record, you can add some facial expression to your lip sync quickly and easily.
Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering or even with iPhone tracking.
You can also quickly add more facial animation details by using the Face Puppet tool. Here you can see that you can control individual facial features like the eyes by using separate profiles. But you can also use expression presets to control various facial features together with simple mouse movements. On top of that, you can also use sliders in the Face Key Editor to animate specific blend shapes on a keyframe-by-keyframe basis as a final level of refinement.
iClone MetaHuman Live Link brings MetaHumans like me to life. This is much more easier and manageable than you imagine. Just focus on your creative directing and storytelling instead of controlling hundreds of rigs. Let us talk with accurate lip syncing and emote us with intuitive facial puppeteering or even with iPhone tracking.
Let's take a look at a couple of tweaks we can make in Unreal now. Normally, you'll need to press play before animating your character in Unreal. However, you can also go to the Actor Blueprint and create a Live Link skeletal animation component. After that's been added, you'll need to add in an ARKit setup function and link it up. Once that's finished, you'll be able to drive the animation to your MetaHuman in Unreal without the need to press the play button first. There are some limitations between iClone characters and MetaHumans to be aware of. In iClone, the eye blink slider used in the Face Key Editor allows you to enter in a negative value to have an even wider eye opening result. However, this negative value will not translate over to your MetaHuman character in Unreal. If you want to open your MetaHuman character's eyes wider, you can use the eye wide sliders instead. On that note, there is also a disparity between the tongue slider strengths in iClone and Unreal. You can see here that the results will generally be much stronger in iClone, so this is something to be aware of. Let's talk a bit about how to increase your FPS next in order to get the smoothest results between the two programs. The frame rate in Unreal is around 30 frames per second while playing the animation in iClone. When switching to the Unreal window, the FPS will go up to between 50 and 60 frames per second, and iClone will go down to 40 to 50. The first thing you can do is to change your real-time render quality to quick mode, which saves on video memory. You can see the FPS go up slightly after that. Additionally, you can ensure that you have the timeline closed. Once the timeline's closed, you'll see that the FPS will suddenly jump to between 60 and 70, which is more like it. In Unreal, you can also change the engine scalability settings to adjust render quality. A lower setting value will increase the FPS result. You can also go into viewport options and change the screen percentage as well. A lower value here will also help FPS. Finally, you can go into editor preferences and disable the use less CPU and in background option as well. That's a quick overview of doing facial animation on your MetaHuman characters in Unreal Engine using iClone Live Link. Please be sure to check out our other tutorials, including the one that is specifically for body animation if you're animating your character's body. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.